On this episode of Made for Glory, we'll focus on the second of Jesus' seven last words from the cross, where he says, "Truly I tell you, this day you will be with me in paradise." One of the most striking aspects of the crucifixion of Jesus is that he's crucified between two thieves, because crucifixion was a Roman punishment for those who were threats, who were dangers to the establishment. That when we talk about Jesus being crucified by the Roman Empire, they did that because they were afraid of him. They were afraid of the people that were following him. They were afraid of his words. They were afraid of what he might do. And so they crucified him. And the two men that were crucified on either side of Jesus are described as two thieves, and they were being punished for their crimes against the Roman Empire. And it's interesting the response of these two thieves, because one of them looks at Jesus and basically says, like, "Look, man, if you're the Messiah, save us. You know, you've done miracles before. You should be able to get us out of this. Save yourself and us." And basically, someone who's refusing to recognize their own guilt. He's someone who doesn't recognize his own complicity with the sin and darkness of this world, but basically just kind of ignores his own guilt, and so wants Jesus to just save him so he can go about sinning. And maybe that's you. Maybe that's been you at different times in your life where you were doing something that was profoundly hurting yourself or hurting somebody else, hurting your relationship, and you just weren't able to see it. And maybe any time that you talk to the Lord, it was just basically, "Lord, just save me from this, but don't change my heart." And that's the first thief. But then the second thief has this amazing response to Jesus. And I think it's something that maybe we should ponder, as you look at Jesus on the cross, to say, "Can I be more like this second thief, this thief that recognizes that he has sinned, recognizes that he has done things that have hurt himself, have hurt others, have hurt his relationship with God, and in a sense that he deserves his punishment." But from that place, he asks the Lord, "Jesus, remember me. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." And I think that's really an important prayer. There's something beautiful that happens at every single Mass where we pray the Confiteor. And the Confiteor is this prayer where we confess to God and to one another that we have sinned. And we say these words, that I have sinned through my fault, through my most grievous fault. That it wasn't somebody else who caused me to sin. It wasn't society that made me sin. But in the midst of society, in the midst of the brokenness of this world, that I myself have chosen to do things that have hurt myself, that have hurt God, that have hurt others. And because of that, I'm in need of God's mercy. So that beautiful repentance that this second thief shows to Jesus is something that we can seek to emulate. "Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner, but I pray and beg that you remember me when you come into your kingdom, that when you enter into your glory, that you will remember me." And then Jesus' response to that second thief is so incredible. And this comes to us from Luke chapter 23, where Jesus says, "Truly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." That Jesus looks at the thief and his misery, his brokenness, but also his repentance, and says right there that I want to meet you, and says, "Truly, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." So wherever you are in your walk with the Lord, maybe trying to be more like the good thief, as he's often called, to recognize your sinfulness, your brokenness, but that nobody, no matter how far you are, no matter how many sins you've accumulated, no matter what crimes you've committed, that the Lord can and will forgive you if you call out to him today.